Hi guys, this is Sophie and today we'll be doing a core series, and I want you to understand the core is not just the front, it's also the back, the side. So we'll be working everything, the upper core, the lower core and the back side as well. Today we're gonna take it up a notch, so if you're ready, I'm ready. We'll just start with a little neck stretch. So pull your neck to the left. Chin towards your shoulder and pull it in. Cool. And then the other side. Pull your chin towards your shoulder. And a little arm circles to open up those arms and shoulders. I'm ready. We're just going to start in a plank position and do whatever feels comfortable for you. So if you're a beginner, just be on your knees here, but advance, you're gonna take it up to your toes. We're just going to hold it here for 30 seconds. If you tremble, that's nice, it means it's working. Do abs, they don't breathe. So I want you to focus on exhaling longer and work that core. Lift back into a downward facing dog and stretch those hamstrings. When you pull back and feel the stretch in your palms and hamstrings, and bring it back to plank and drag it down into an outward facing dog. Tomorrow and the day after that and the week after that, bang, she was like, two more planks. Yes, we're gonna do three more. Drop it down, round up facing dog, and then just stay here. Bring your right leg up and bring it to touch your left. Obliques. Ooh, so nice, doesn't it? Bring your hand back. We're just warming up. Bring your left leg up. Bring it to touch your right tricep. If you're not here, you'll be here. Utakoki nikumbuka. One more time.
job, the teacher always told me to take a child's course whenever I need it. And at this moment, we just take one day and we go back.
We're not relaxing. We're pumped up again for the last time. This is the last time I'm going to put in plank. If you're tired, like me. I'm also human.
I'll just drop it down.
We're going to do 5 of these. I'm just going to do 2 more, show you that you can do this with the correct form if you're a beginner. And child's pose. Advance, let's do 1 more. And drop down to your knees. The back part. So just exhale and lift. So what you're going to do, you're just going to bring our hands to the side, and the next time you lift, just pull your arms up. Make sure your nose is facing the mat. And really feel that back engage. Lift your hips up. Feel your legs, feel your belly. Yeah, and just drop down. If you're a beginner, you don't have to lift your legs, but I'm going to challenge you. Extra over here and a little bit extra over there, just because I can, and then drop down. Repeat that 1 more time. What I like to think about when doing this is when I'm wearing that dress and the waist looks really nice, I feel good, and afterwards I'm in a better mood, not just when wearing a dress, after the workout. Just lift. 10 more seconds. Now let's do 15. You're like, why? Why? Why something? Because I can't. Back over here.
open up, you can literally move through water without moving your legs. Or if you're intermediate, legs here, and just move the hands, this is going to work your back core. It'll be tightening. Your back obliques will be on fire. One.
Going to begin your knees to 90 degrees
And give me three more. Over here, really breathe and let's take a long, slow walk. You can place your hands here. because of your faith and drama. Control that situation, your inner fight. Before we do that series again, relaxing class, I insist. Stretching out your legs. We're going straight back into those features. Good actually to work your glutes and your every little bit. off to your side. Fist up or whatever. And slowly inhale and exhale. Push it up. And just hold it here. Like a bridge pose. This is like a bridge. Someone can come. A little kid can walk there and go to the other side. That's what I like to do. Toss and not focus so much. Sometimes I want to fall. Come and come. Lift up. Feel your glutes engage, your core. And feel your lower abs, your core, your upper abs. Oh my God. This man is just walking over you. And he's feeling nice, you know? Ooh. I like walking core because I can play with my little siblings. I can carry people around. And slowly inhale, drop it down. Strong core, you can carry your kids around, bring your elbows to the side, exhale, really lift up and breathe, don't hold in too much, let it go, work out from back to like to leave all the skin, you're going to be here for 20 seconds, the other day I was playing with my nephew and he was like, you can really carry me nicely, unlike, nah, I'm not going to mention it. But that felt really nice because I've been watching my core. Ooh, and just drop it off my ass, my glutes. Ooh, did you hear that? One more time. And we're just going to hold it here. This time, what I want you to do is bring it down and bring it up. So we're really focusing on the breath and the core as well. Bring it all the way to the mat. Just feel that air in between and lift up. And inhale. Don't touch the mat. Don't touch it. Really push and feel the side of your core, the lower core. You're getting glutes, you're getting core, you're getting back, and push it up. Don't touch the floor at all, just leave the little space where you can feel the air. And five more. Lift up. I like to touch the little bit so I can feel my core engage. This last one here for 5 seconds. 1, 2, lift up higher. 4, 5, and drop it gently. Don't drop. It's not a punishment. It's a workout. You know you feel like. Anyway, bring your knees again here. So what you're going to do next?
Just bring your arms to the side. Knees bent. And you're going to lift up. If you come into the next level with me, hands by your side, lengthen the liver, strengthen your legs, you push through your legs, and just hold it here. You can look over your toes, you can look at the sky, but hold it here. Thank you.
the other side. That stretch on your lower back. You've been working core there.
Actually,